Good morning. I'm presenting a study on comparison of visual acuity in children with good and poor spectacle wear compliance. AO guidelines for spectacle prescription in children is a case-based scenario. It includes multiple factors like age, type of refractive error, level of refractive error, presence of strabismus into consideration. So prescription for glasses for children includes important factors like prevention of amblyopia, and we also have to consider emmetropization while prescribing glasses. Poor compliance with spectacle wear in children is a major issue. Our objectives of our study was to compare the best corrected visual acuity in children with refractive error who are compliant with spectacle wear versus children who are non-compliant. To estimate the adherence to AAO guidelines while prescribing spectacles, to identify the various reasons for non-compliance with spectacle wear. It was a prospective hospital-based study. Children of age group 1 to 15 years wearing spectacles for a minimum of 1 month were included in the study. The vision was assessed using either Snellen's or Cardiff's based on the age of the child. Wearing spectacles for more than 50% of the waking hours was considered as good compliance. 97 children were included in the study. Mean age was 9.5 years. The adherence to AAO guidelines was present in 70%. For cylinder, it was 73.29%, and for sphere, it was 82%. Simple myopia and simple myopic astigmatism were the most common refractive errors in our study. When we estimated using a questionnaire the amount of supervision that was present by an adult at school and home, it was more than 80%. Around 69 and 68% children had good compliance at school and home. The most common reason for non-compliance with spectacle wear was uncomfortable to wear glasses, followed by broken glasses which were not replaced. When we saw the difference in the mean vision improvement with children with good compliance versus children with poor compliance, there was no difference in the mean vision improvement between the good and the poor compliant groups. Around 60% children showed a two-line improvement with a mean spectacle wear of around 35 months. While considering the AAO guidelines, even whether glasses were prescribed based on AAO guidelines or not, the difference in the mean vision improvement in the good versus poor compliant group was not statistically significant. But the odds of children with good compliance with spectacle wear having a two-line improvement in BCVA were 1.35 times those of children with poor compliance. Though 30% had poor compliance, more than 50% of those showed two-line or more of improvement, probably due to emmetropization. Since most of the children were myope, they had a good near vision stimulus which helped in improving the vision, or less than 50% time spectacle wear was enough for the stimulation. Non-improvement in good compliance group was due to dense amblyopia. Improvement in vision in good compliance children, though was not statistically significant, was clinically significant. Considering both spherical and astigmatic power, adherence to AAO guidelines in our study was only 70%, probably due to the dilemma in prescribing glasses for children with compound or mixed astigmatism. Though non-compliant with spectacle wear, those children who are non-compliant spectacle wear should be encouraged to wear spectacles for at least a cumulative period of more than 50% of waking hours. But in our study, we have seen that children who have not owned for more than 50% of waking hours also had shown improvement. Adherence to AAO guidelines may not be practical in all situations. We did not find a difference in the two groups where this was concerned. It would be more relevant and practical to prescribe on a case-based scenario.